enjoy that experience. Backstage pass, all access to what's been happening around Kampala. Now, since it's Woman Crush Wednesday, I had a little chit-chat with Derek Dash and asked him to have a woman for the show, a lady. Now, this lady is a director slash producer. Can you believe it? Those are very few wild words, by the way. Derek Dash, we'll be right back.
Welcome to yet another special edition of the Flick Radio on Urban Television, getting into what has been making trends as far as the film industry can be related to. Now, today in studio, I do have a lady by the name of Salma, who will give me an update about her new movie called Mothers. Salma, how are you doing?
I'm okay, how are you doing?
Not bad.
How's been your day?
Let's
talk Mothers. What is Mothers all about?
Mothers is all about the choices the mothers make in life and how these choices reflect into their children.
Okay.
Yes.
Is it based on a true story? Because there are a lot of choices that mothers do make. So I don't know if you're looking at one particular choice in this movie, or how did you even zero down to this kind of synopsis for a movie like this?
I wouldn't really say that it's based on a true story, but all I can say is that it is based on the life events. Yeah, the events that happen in our daily lives. Mm-hmm. Mothers make choices, and then at the end of the day, these choices are reflected onto their children, because you make a choice as one, but you do not think of what is going to come out of the choice that you're making. So basically, that is what it's about.
So looking at this movie and the title of it and the synopsis, the main subject here is mothers.
Yes.
Mothers are very delicate people to deal with. Now, let's zero it down to the diction or to the lines that you did use in your movie. How long did it take you and your team to agree on these particular lines?
Of course, it took us some time before we could actually come out with a script, because let me say, when we're writing, you don't write at once, then come out with a script and present it. Yeah, you write, we have phases. You take the script for editing, so someone tells you, hey, you put this line, but it won't work. So you have to get this out, put this. So we had to pass through all the phases of the writing, then we presented the script, then put it into production.
Now, looking at the first experience, this is the first time you're doing a series. Why, of all things, decide to do a series? Why not a movie or even a short film? Because the last time I did interact with a couple of directors, they say it is very, it's advisable for one to begin small before they get to jump on a huge concept like a series. So why do you set it off on a higher pace?
This is what I'm going to say. Like how you called Derek, and I am called Salma. So we look at things differently. Mm-hmm. You get it. So if Derek thinks that it's so hard to start with a series, Salma thinks it is easier to start with a series.
Okay.
You understand? Mm-hmm. So that is the only thing I can say about it. Mm-hmm. So to me, I thought it was easier to start with a series, because I wanted to have something that is long, that is going to keep me going, since this is my first production. Other than doing a full length production, then it's just one production. Then I go into the market, start nashing. So I said, no, I need to do a long production, so I can keep moving and get platform, because it's my first production and it's my first time into the industry. Yes.
Talking about it being your first time in the industry, what exactly tipped you off into doing film? Because you are joining an industry that is just literally growing at a very fast rate with a very high competition. Now, what exactly inspired you to join this kind of industry?
I must say that I've been here, I've been there before. But I've been there before not as a writer, I've been there before not as a producer, and not as a director. I've just been working with people. You get on other people's projects. So as a director and a producer, so I am here for the first time.
So do you think you have what it takes to keep up with this speedy growing industry?
Then I wouldn't be there. Yes.
All right, interesting. Now let's come back and still talk about Mothers. Mothers is a series. Do you intend to have it, profound into more seasons and more seasons? Or it's going to be a season one blockbuster and that's it?
No, not really. Yeah, it's going to run for a long time, because these are mothers that we're talking about, and these are life events that we're talking about. Well, with the life events, it's so broad. It's so hard to limit, you understand? Unless you just wake up in the morning and say, I should stop here. But life events, they are so broad. You just can't cut them into a season or two seasons.
What are the biggest challenges that you did encounter trying to have the production of Mothers?
Wow.
Mm.
The challenges. Of course the challenges are there.
Because I assume you have a lump sum of them, bearing in mind that this is your first production. Yes. What is some of them?
Before I started the production, I met a few guys. Like how you meet someone and you're talking to them about the production, you're talking to them about yourself, about you being new into the industry, about you coming up to do a series, and of course everyone gives you their opinion, but at the end of the day the choice is yours to make. So you meet someone and they tell you, are you going to do a series? Like really? Do you really have to do a series? No, come on. You get. So if you listen to someone who is telling you that, you're going to end up not doing the series. You get. So then you meet someone else tells you, you know what, the industry is so challenging, you can't do this. Then you meet someone else, you think they're going to give you an audience, then they don't give you audience because they think you're down there and they're up there. So yeah, challenges are there.
Okay, quite interesting. Now, when does this movie get to be available for the people on the market?
The series itself is out of post-production, so we are just working with a few marketing agencies to make sure that we give it a network.
Okay.
Yes.
And where do you see yourself in about 5 years from now, knowing that you're newly established in the industry? In about 5 years, where do you see yourself?
Well, I'll start by saying that my lifetime motto is working for others to emulate.
Okay.
So I believe in 5 years time, inshallah, I will have worked for the rest of the people to emulate.
Alright, interesting. There you have it, of course, some of the words that are coming in from Salma, who seems to be very new on the market, but she has the strong belief that she can actually bring a much better work as far as the industry can get to represent. Now, of course, I'm going to post a trailer on my Facebook page, which is Aina Derek. Now, I'm going to ask you to just get over there and let me know, what do you think about her work? Do you think she has what it takes to maintain it in this fast-growing competitive industry? And then I'll definitely be reading some of the comments that will be coming through. Until next time, I'll see you guys on the timeline. Derek Dasha is my movie ambassador name. And of course, before I do sign out, be sure to come and catch these interesting movies down here at Century Cinema, showing The Spy Who Dumped Me. I'll see you guys next time. And don't forget to be safe. Don't drink and drive. I'm out. Peace.
If your role model is someone like Naomi Campbell, then you're definitely going to love the lady who we're going to have for Woman Crush Wednesday. She's a young 22-year-old who contested in Miss Uganda 2018 and was Miss Photogenic and Miss Talent. She goes by the name of Neema Sandra, and she's my Woman Crush Wednesday. Trust me, you're going to enjoy this show because she's a ball of happiness. She is too much. She's my bunch of joy. We'll be right back with that interview.